Hi, this is John from PortableFreewareGames.com, and I'm here to show you a game on the website. So if you go to your browser, and you type in PortableFreewareGames.com, I want you to choose the Games option, scroll down to the bottom of that page, choose page 21, and scroll down that page to the fifth option, the fifth game. This is it here, Tetris Runner 1.3. When you click on that Wii image, and that'll take you to the download page where you've got a video for the game, you've got a description of the game, and you've got a contact link for the game author's Twitter account here, and you've also got a download link. So let's download this. Save. And this is the file here that you'll download, tetrisrunner.exe. It's an .exe file, it's an executable file, and like every game on PortableFreewareGames.com, it doesn't have to be installed to run. So let's double click this. And as you can see, it opens out into this nice menu here, where you've got the name of the website, presents, the name of the game, and you've got four buttons. You've got a PISA button, you've got a README button, you've got a free VPN button, and you've got a game button. Now starting from the top left, the PISA button is the Paid Internet Survey App button, and it's basically a miniature mobile website that details the 25 best survey websites on the internet. Basically websites that you sign into, you answer a questionnaire, and you get paid. Now there's 25 of these websites listed in PISA, and out of that 25, 5 are completely free to join, so there's no financial risk. And a further 10 offer a full 60-day money-back guarantee. So if you're not happy with how much money you earn after 60 days, after paying your subscription fee, and you can just get your money back. It's a great big thing. All you really need is an email address and some free time, and you can start earning money off the internet. And that's PISA. Underneath PISA, we've got the README, which is basically instructions for the game and copyright owners for the game, stuff like that. And over to the right, the free VPN. This is a link to a free virtual private network software. Now, anybody that spends any amount of time on the internet must be aware that there's people out there that's constantly trying to invade your privacy, whether it's hackers, government agencies, or internet service providers. They all seem fascinated with finding out what you're looking at and what you're viewing and where you're visiting, whatever, on the internet. And a free virtual private network would put a stop to that and give you back your privacy. The one I recommend is it gives you, 2 gigabytes a month free with data transfer, and anything more than that, you have to pay for it. But it's very reasonably priced, and 2 gigabytes a month should be about enough for anybody that just surfs the internet and watches videos here and there. It's fast and it's free and it's good, and I recommend it. And that's free VPN. And last but not least is a game button to play the game. Let's play this game. And this is just a wee configuration box you get with some Unity games. You just click play. And this is the game just starting up. And as you can see, in the middle at the bottom of the screen, it says press enter to log in. And if you click enter, it'll ask you to sign in using your GameJolt name, username. I've actually got a GameJolt username, but I'm not going to use it because I'm going to assume that you don't have a username. I'm just going to play as a guest, so enter as guest. And now we're ready to start. And this will now be a good time to explain what the game's all about. Tetris Runner. That wasn't a very good start. Tetris Runner, basically you're running in a maze, and there's obstacles in the maze. And the obstacles are Tetris blocks. Some of them you can jump over, some of them you can run over, and some of them you have to avoid. The game is completely random. The game is completely random. It's different every time you play it, and it's a well-made, addictive Wii game, and I like it. So let's play again. And here we go. As you can see, you're running on a run up that one there. And avoid those two up the middle. Dead again. On the scoreboard, as you can see at the very top of the screen, my score was 1300.
you've got a scoreboard here, and if you get to 50,000, it unlocks another bit of the game, and 100,000 unlocks more of the game, 250,000 unlocks even more of the game, and 500,000 unlocks all of the game. I'm not doing very well right now, I'm only at 1,300. So let's play again, let's get another wee try. And here we go. You can see him avoiding these wee blocks here, you can actually jump over them. Then again, 3,400 is better than I've been, but still not good enough to get on the scoreboard. Well, actually, because I'm playing as a guest, I won't be able to get on the scoreboard. You need to have an account with GameJolt to get a username to get on the scoreboard. So let's give it one more try and we'll leave it at that. And here we go. And the further along you go, the faster the game gets. So it gets more and more difficult. Dead. I'll leave it at that, I think. I don't think you need any more instructions on how to play this game. It's a simple idea, but it's very well made. And that's the kind of games that I like. Simple, but addictive. So I'm going to leave it at that. So I hope you download this game. I hope you enjoy this game. I hope you have a lot of fun playing this game. And I hope you subscribe. Thanks for watching.